right? Right. Sit, settle first. So, in the last class, we discussed, about lipoprotein metabolism, right? And today we'll be focusing on many topics. You'll have class till 9, is it okay? Tomorrow is a Sunday, right? Work hard now. So, first of all, we'll be discussing about the muscles of the neck region, okay? Why? Because this is the basic for understanding the triangles of the neck. Triangles of the neck is a very high yield, even you know that. So, for understanding the triangles of the neck, you have to know the muscles of the neck region, okay? So, first of all, what I'll draw is, I'll draw the angle of the mandible. For example, look here. If I'm lifting my head, so this becomes the inferior angle of my mandible, okay? So, for example, if I draw the inferior angle of my mandible, okay, let me draw it here. Right, so this is my inferior angle of the mandible when I lift or when I bend my head backward. Clear? Now, below this, so what is this one, this process here, tell me? Very good. This is called as mental process. Now, just below the mental process, what do I have? Hyoid bone. So, below the mental process here, I mean below the mandible, I have my hyoid bone here. This is hyoid bone, right? Now, below the hyoid, what do I have? What? Thyroid. Below that I have sternum. Here we don't focus on cricoid. So that is the reason why I'm not telling about cricoid, right? So this is the inferior angle of the mandible. And here I have my thyroid bone, below that thyroid cartilage, and here the manubrium and the sternum. Now attached on both the sides, what do I have? Attached on both the sides, I have what? Ribs? No. Very good. Attached on both the sides, I have my clavicle over here. Whatever. Right. If I make a neck line over here. Right. So, now look here. See, this is the inferior angle of the or inferior edge of the or inferior margin of the mandible, right? Now, when I turn like this, here I have a bone just behind my ear. What is that? Bone, mastoid bone, right? So, for example, this is my mastoid bone here, okay? This is my mastoid bone. Now, hanging on to the muscles, now what are the different types of muscles? See, the first muscle is, it originates from, see, you listen here, I am not going to write the origins and insertions because with the diagram only it will be clear. Origin of this muscle is from the inferior edge of the mandible or inferior margin of the mandible. And next, this muscle all the way passes towards your hyoid bone, right? And this muscle ends near the hyoid bone with a tendon like this. Clear? Now, next what happens is, upon this hyoid bone, you have another tendon. Now, this tendon hooks this tendon of this muscle, okay? Now, from here starts another muscle. Now, look here. This muscle, all the way it goes and inserts to your... No, not hyoid. Mastoid process. Now, this muscle, it is having two parts. This is called as the anterior part and this is called as the posterior part, right? So, of course, they are looking, all of them are looking on single plane, but if I am lifting up my head like this, right? Now, the muscle which you can see here, this is called as the anterior part of the muscle, and muscle which is on the back like this, this is called as the posterior part of the muscle. So, this is called anterior belly, this is called as posterior belly, right? And the name of the muscle is digastric muscle. So, this is anterior belly of digastric and this is your very good, posterior belly of digastric, right? So, the same thing on here as well. So, this is anterior belly of digastric muscle and here you have got a tendon, And upon the hyoid bone also you have another tendon. What is this tendon which is hooking up this muscle? This tendon is called as intermediate tendon. Okay, this tendon is called as intermediate tendon. Now all the way it goes and inserts to your mastoid process. Now you know the origins and insertions of this, right? So what is the name of this muscle, tell me? Very good. The name of this muscle is diagastric muscle. Diagastric muscle. Diagastric muscle has got two bellies. One is called as the anterior belly, another one is called as your posterior belly. So this is called as your anterior belly and here comes your posterior belly, right? Now what is important here? The important thing is the functions. The important thing is the functions, right? For example, see this anterior belly of diagastric muscle, what exactly happens is, if this anterior belly of diagastric muscle is contracted, right? When you contract this anterior belly of diagastric, when you are contracting this muscle, what is happening? This muscle is attached to mandible, so the mandible is depressed down. So open, as a result, what happens? The mouth opens. So depression of mandible happens because of, very good, that to which, anterior. Which part? Very good, anterior belly is responsible for depression of your mandible, clear? Posterior belly, come to the posterior belly here, look here now, everyone. This is the posterior belly. Now if I am contracting the posterior belly, what is happening? The hyoid bone is elevated up. Is it making sense? Right? So when I am contracting the posterior belly, the hyoid bone is elevated up. So posterior belly is responsible for elevation of hyoid bone. So overall, what is the function of diagastric muscle? Depression of mandible, elevation of hyoid bone. Clear? Done? Now next muscle, if I remove this diagastric muscle, behind this diagastric muscle I have one more muscle. Okay, see, for example, okay, let me draw it with another color, with the orange. See, behind this diagastric muscle I have got another muscle like this. Now this is the muscle that is located behind my diagastric muscle. Now this muscle is located behind the diagastric muscle and the name of this muscle is? Very good. The name of this muscle, the name of the second muscle is mylohyoid muscle. The name of this muscle is mylohyoid muscle. Clear? Done? Now in this mylohyoid muscle, what is the function of this mylohyoid muscle is, for example, if this let us take an example like this. See, this entirely is the mylohyoid muscle. Okay, on the top it is attached to the inferior margin of mandible, on the bottom it is attached to the hyoid bone. For example, if I am contracting this muscle, look here, if I am contracting this muscle, the top fibers are pulling it downward and the bottom fibers are pulling upward. You see, you are seeing it, right? The top fibers of mylohyoid are pulling the mandible downward like this and the bottom fibers which are attached to hyoid bone, they are pulling it up. So even mylohyoid has also got two functions. What are the two functions? One is depression of mandible, another one is elevation of hyoid. The same functions. Clear so far? Any doubt? No? Right. Next one, I am going to draw it with the green to avoid confusion. Look here, another muscle. If, for example, see here, this, what is this process? What is this bone called as? Mastoid bone, right? Hanging down to the mastoid bone, I have a process here. What is this? Styloid. On both the sides, I have, yeah, this is called as my styloid process. This is called as my styloid process. Now attached, if I attach a muscle all the way from the styloid process to the hyoid bone, then what will be the name? Stylohyoid. Very good, stylohyoid muscle. So this is this green color muscle which is very thin, this is called as stylohyoid muscle. So origin is from the styloid process and it is getting inserted to the hyoid bone. So here comes your style of head muscle. You are clear with this, right? So all these even stylohyoid, when I am contracting this muscle, what is happening? The hyoid bone is elevated up. So the next muscle is stylohyoid muscle. Clear? Yes or no? Stylohyoid muscle. And what is the function of this? Only one function: elevation of hyoid bone. Elevation of hyoid bone. Next important thing which I would like to discuss is, look here, this orange color muscle which I drew behind, what is this? Mylohyoid. Mylohyoid is located outside, right? The same position, mylohyoid is in origin from the inferior edge of the mandible and inserted to the hyoid bone, right? The same muscle, if I bring another muscle and I put it in the mouth, below the tongue, then what will it become? See, here, this is your mandible, right? Now, this part is your outer edge of the mandible, right? This is the inner one. Here I have the tongue, right? Previously, one muscle was attached from the inferior margin of the mandible and all the way from here it originated and inserted to the hyoid bone. Clear? Same way, now there is another muscle in the oral cavity attached from the inferior edge of the mandible, right, within the oral cavity, and it goes and attaches to the hyoid bone, right? Origin and insertion is same, but the location of the muscle is different. One muscle is outside here, another muscle is inside here, below the tongue. This is called as genohyoid muscle, okay? The name of the, I can't draw it now, so that muscle is called as genohyoid muscle. The fourth muscle is genohyoid. Origin and insertion is same as mylohyoid muscle. Okay, origin and insertion is same as mylohyoid muscle. Now, function of genohyoid, the same thing. What are the functions of mylohyoid muscle? Depression of mandible, right? It has got two functions. One is depression of mandible, same like mylohyoid. Same way, elevation of hyoid bone, same like mylohyoid. Clear? There is one additional function. What is the additional function is? See, when you are swallowing food or water or something, when you are swallowing food, this is called as the floor of the oral cavity. Inside, that is called as the floor of the oral cavity. When you are swallowing food, initially, in the first second, the floor will be elevated or depressed. See, you put your fingers here and swallow. For in the first second, it is little bit elevated and again it is depressed. So that little bit elevation is done by this genohyoid muscle. Okay, it is responsible for elevation of floor of the mouth during swallowing. Clear, everyone? Right. So these are the muscles. How many muscles we have discussed so far? We have discussed, one is called as the digastric muscle. Clear? And the next muscle which we discussed was what? We have discussed the digastric muscle. We have discussed the mylohyoid muscle, stylohyoid and genohyoid. So all these muscles have a common function. What is a common function? Depression of mandible, elevation of hyoid bone. So all these muscles are located above the hyoid bone, right? So I have to call these muscles as suprahyoid or infrahyoid. So all these muscles are called as suprahyoid muscles. All these muscles are called as suprahyoid muscles. Write it very fast. You have a doubt? Yeah, Gino hired. Spelling mistake. I didn't study English well during my... I was a poor student, so... Overall, you understood the concept? Concept is important. Right, anyways. So, after this, now we'll be discussing the muscles which are located below the hyoid bone. Okay? For example, if I draw a muscle which is originating from thyroid cartilage, right? Which is originating from thyroid cartilage and right away it is going and inserting to your hyoid bone. So, this is thyroid cartilage, this is hyoid bone, and the muscle is thyrohyoid muscle. So, the first muscle is thyrohyoid. Now, this is the first muscle. Now, function of this muscle. Look, function of this muscle is, what it is doing is, one side, if I am contracting this muscle, the hyoid bone is elevated or depressed down? Depressed. Hyoid bone is, if I am pulling it down, hyoid bone is depressed. So, depression of hyoid. And other function is, see, where is hyoid bone? It is here. Hyoid bone is here. Below that, all this region is the laryngeal region. This is hyoid bone, below that laryngeal region, right? So, one function is, if it is pulling down, hyoid bone is depressed. Another function is, when it is contracting, the entire larynx is elevated up. Yes or no? Entire larynx is elevated up. Any doubt? No? So, it has also got two functions, depression of hyoid and elevation of larynx. Clear? Clear with this? Next muscle, it originates, look here, this muscle originates all the way from the sternum, exactly speaking the manubrium, right, the manubrium of the sternum, and it is going and inserting to where? Thyroid. So, you have to call this as sternothyroid muscle. Sternothyroid muscle. Clear? So, the next muscle is sternothyroid muscle. Sternothyroid muscle. The same function. See, when I am contracting this muscle, what is happening? There is depression of hyoid bone. So, of course, depression, if see, it doesn't matter that if it is directly attached to hyoid only, there will be depression. This is attached to thyroid. When I'm talking about this muscle, do you think there is no muscle like this? We also have this muscle, right? So, when I'm contracting this muscle, the force is exerted upon this, and this in turn is impended upon this, and this in turn is impended upon the hyoid bone. So, overall, you're depressing the hyoid bone, right? Next. Look here, another muscle, origin of this muscle takes place from the sternum region, okay? And all the way this muscle goes and inserts to your hyoid bone. Origin is from the sternum and it goes and inserts to the hyoid bone on both the sides here. Sternohyoid muscle, right? Tell me the function. Depression of the hyoid bone. So, the third muscle is sternohyoid. Depression of hyoid bone. Everyone clear? Next, the last muscle, look here. This muscle originates from the hyoid bone, like this. Same like digastric muscle, this muscle has got two bellies, right? So, this is the muscle, all the way like this. And look here now, this muscle also has got, what? This muscle also has got intermediate tendon. But this intermediate tendon is located on the clavicle. Okay? this intermediate tendon is located on the clavicle, and from here this muscle is hooked up, and there is another part of this muscle which is attached to the clavicle. On both the sides, obviously I'm not going to draw there. So on both the sides you have one part of the muscle attached to the hyoid bone, right? Another part of the muscle, it is the origin of this muscle is from the hyoid bone, it is inserting to the intermediate tendon. Another muscle origin is from the clavicle, and it is also inserting to the tendon. Same way, origin is from the inferior edge of the mandible, anterior belly of digastric, origin is from the inferior edge of the mandible and inserting to the intermediate tendon of the hyoid bone. Next, posterior belly, origin from the mastoid process, and it is inserting to the intermediate tendon of hyoid bone. The same concept applied here. Now this muscle, this is called as what? Omohyoid muscle. And what are these two bellies? Superior belly, inferior belly, not anterior and posterior. Because see, why superior and inferior is, see, this is superior belly, right? Inferior belly is like this. So both of them are located in the same plane. Previously we had one muscle here, another muscle on the back, so we named it as posterior. But now one is on the top, one is on the bottom, so you named it as superior and inferior belly of omohyoid muscle. So here we have got omohyoid muscle, omohyoid muscle. Now what is the action when I'm contracting it down? What is happening? Depression of the hyoid bone. So overall in a bird view, what we need to understand is there are a group of muscles called suprahyoid, there are a group of muscles called infrahyoid. Suprahyoid are responsible for the elevation of hyoid bone and depression of mandible. Infrahyoid are responsible for depression of hyoid bone and elevation of larynx. Clear? So overall you need to know the functions of these muscles in this way. So it is just a basic concept of what are the functions of suprahyoid and infrahyoid. Okay? Now you understood list of suprahyoid and list of infrahyoid. Now you apply your own mnemonics and remember this if you want. I think this will be easy if you remember like this. TOS. Okay? This one I don't know. So you are clear with this? If you are clear with this, this is the basic for the triangles of the neck. Now shall I go? Right.